الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Our picture for today is very beautiful. The setting, it's early in the da'wah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was working hard, very eager to achieve his goal. And he was talking to the important people in Quraysh, inviting them to Islam, talking to them with utmost kindness, it happened apparently on the streets, and in the wrong time, in the wrong place, a very poor, simple man who happened to be blind came from nowhere hollering, "Oh Muhammad, teach me of what God had taught you." The man did not see the Prophet's sallallahu alaihi wasallam complexions of his face, but the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not happy because of his interruption of very important talk with very important people. Utba ibn Rabi'a, Abu Jahl, Amr ibn Hisham, and Al-Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib. So he frowned and turned his back towards him and continued his discussion with those important figures of Quraysh. Then when he finished his conversation, he left home. However, on the way, the wahy, the revelation, the archangel Jibril came down with few verses of the Quran, which has in it a itab. And itab is 50 shades in color. Starts from friendly reproach to gentle reproof, to admonition, to disapprove, all the way to rebuke. So here it is a kind of itab, a reproach to bring the attention of the Prophet, peace be upon him, from God, that the mean or the end does not justify the mean. The Muslims should be all along very kind, very friendly, regardless what you are looking for at the end. Here the emphasis on the importance of everyone, regardless if he is poor or needy or in the socio-economic ranking comes at the bottom, because he is a human being. And all these measurements from outside, they are irrelevant. In this lesson, we learn that everyone is somebody. Everyone is important. So here in this lesson, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam every time he would see that man who happened to be blind, and his name is Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktoum, he would welcome him with a smile, interrupt everything he's doing, spread his garment on the ground for him to sit on it, and always bring that story, that revelation, those verses, and tell him, welcome for the one who God reproached me because of him. Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktoum, in many occasions, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is out of town, he would appoint him to be his deputy in his place. He was the second muezzin, the one who calls for the prayers after Bilal ibn Rabah. He was dignified and important for every companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In Islam, people are equal, they are human beings, they are important, they are like the teeth of a comb. الناس سواسية كأسنان المشط. So the Arabic text says, بينما رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يناجي عتبة ابن ربيعة وأبا جهل ابن هشام والعباس ابن عبد المطلب وكان يتصدى لهم كثيرا ويحرص عليهم أن يؤمنوا فأقبل إليه رجل أعمى يقال له عبد الله ابن أم مكتوم يمشي وينادي بأعلى صوته يا محمد علمني مما علمك الله فأعرض عنه الرسول وعبس كراهية لكلامه وأقبل على الآخرين فلما قضى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نجواه وأخذ ينقلب إلى أهله أمسك الله ببعض بصره وخفق برأسه ثم أنزل عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى فكان بعد ذلك كلما رآه بسط له رداءه قائلا أهلا بمن عاتبني به ربي صلى الله عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله.